today we have with us an artist, actor, social activist, Argadeep Borua. Argadeep, welcome to Eurus Studios presents Cinetail Talks.
Thank you.
After your debut film, Amiss, you received a lot of appreciation from far and wide. How did it feel to get such applauses, love, in such a short period of time?
I mean, obviously you'll feel overwhelmed and humbled. And there's also this fact that with, you know, greater power comes greater responsibility. Mm-hmm. So in a way, you also become more responsible and conscious about your art form.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you have to be more honest when somebody is looking up to you.
Mm-hmm.
So I think that is something that is one of my biggest takeaway from all the loves and accolades that people have showered. And other than that, I think in the very basic level, I'm always being the same person. I think you should not get too, excited or...
Carried away,
exactly. Yeah.
So when you read the script of Amiss, mm-hmm. what was the first thing that clicked you or like how you went forward with it?
Well, as a film student and as a film enthusiast, I was fascinated by the script. And after reading 3 to 4 pages of the script, I could visualize, you know, certain images. And there are also impressions of some of my favorite films that were coming to my mind. So in a way, it was a very enriching and a very fascinating sort of a read while I was reading the script. So yeah, the first impression was very, very, very good. In short, if I have to say.
Like you worked with Bhaskar Hazarika for your film.
Mm-hmm.
So how was it, your experience to work with him as a filmmaker?
Well, it was a life-changing experience in so many ways. The way he handles
mm-hmm.
the whole crew
yeah.
and also the actors. It's very fascinating to see that his approach towards, dealing with the crew or even with the actors is so calm, and he never overburdens you.
Mm-hmm.
So he gives you that space to explore, and that is really fascinating because you never get this feeling of fear or pressure
yeah.
while you're on set, you know. So that is, and for someone like me who was for the first time, you know, was there in front of the camera.
Right.
So sometimes these things becomes very intimidating. So to have him there and to make us feel calm and make us feel composed,
mm-hmm.
I think his role is very important.
Yeah.
And also to understand a script like Amiss, you know, to understand the layers and the subtext.
Yeah.
His way of making us understand was very fascinating. Interestingly, with me, what also happened is like there are certain things or certain emotions. I keep telling this
yeah.
that I sometimes can't able to connect myself with.
Mm-hmm.
So at that point of time, he used to make me listen to music because music is a very important part of my life.
Yeah.
So he used to give me a soundscape, and then accordingly, he used to tell me ki whatever you get out of this soundscape, whatever you feel, you just give me that. So that was a very interesting thing from his end. So yeah, it was a very interesting journey.
Like with the song, you said the music that you've been connected with. Like people have seen you performing, your band that you perform with, the songs that you do. Your recent release, Smriti Rodali.
Mm-hmm.
Can you tell us a little more about it?
Well, it was also a very interesting journey, I would say.
Mm-hmm.
So the director of this music video is Manav Borua. So I have known him for a while, but we worked in a music video called Ali Bat, which was sung by Podinita. So during that shoot, we came across in a more personal level. And then we thought of working out something together.
Mm-hmm.
And one day, Orno, who has composed the song, and Manav thought of getting into a Zoom call.
Mm-hmm.
And again, the whole Corona thing come into
yeah.
the play, and how it actually ended up into something creative
mm-hmm.
like Smriti Rodale. So we sat for a Zoom meeting and we started working on a melody. And then we thought, ki who can write the songs? And then
mm-hmm.
we approached Kukilda, who has written the lyrics. So again, we had a Zoom meeting. So it was a series of Zoom meeting that led to Smriti Rodale. So then we thought and we shared our ideas. So he initially came up with some of his own lines, and then we shared ki there is this feeling of maybe missing someone while watching, while gazing the sky and the stars. And through those series of conversation, we again kept on meeting new or friends like Hunana Dutta, Baido, then Mississippi, Dipannita. So it was a beautiful journey that blossomed through Zoom meetings. And we formed a collective called Bioscope. And yeah, this is how Smriti Rodale happened. And I touch wood, feel that this journey will lead to more possibilities and more creative things.
I really wish the best for that.
Thank you.
Did you always want to be a part of this entertainment world, or did it just come to you spontaneously?
Yeah, entertainment world.
Yeah.
I don't know how to put myself into it, because I always wanted to have the band, and I always wanted to perform on stage. So that is something that was always there in me. I really like the adrenaline rush that you get when you're on stage. You are interacting with the audience. If I can put that into the whole diaspora of entertainment industry, then yes, I was definitely eager to be a part of that industry as such. But as far as films are concerned, I wanted to be there more as a filmmaker.
Okay.
Because that has been my first love always, to make films. So to be a part of the industry as an actor was never in my bucket list also. So it is mostly the filmmaker and the storyteller part that has fascinated me.
We all have inspirations, we inspire, we take inspiration from somebody.
Mm-hmm.
Like, who or what inspired you into this world?
The world itself. I mean, my biggest inspiration has always been nature and environment. And I always tell people that whenever I see river, I feel so calm and I feel so connected. And the whole idea of, you know, letting go and keep flowing has always been there as a source of inspiration. So nature has been my primary source of inspiration. But I'm also very privileged to be in a family where my father has always been there to make me understand about good films and bad films, who introduced me to Satyajit Ray, Hrithik Ghatak, Mrinal Sen, Tarkovsky. And I'm also very blessed to have a family that introduced me to the world of Gwalparia Lokagit. So I think the influence of family has been huge. And I must say that my brother, Chinmoy Borua, has also been a great support. I mean, in this time, I feel that I don't have to worry for my roti kapra makan. Only because I have a shelter like my brother and my family. So yeah, these are my basic or my primary inspirations. And then I also draw a lot of inspiration from my mentors like Rita Banerjee ma'am. So I have had the opportunity to be a part of an initiative called Green Hub.
Yeah.
Where I got to know more about wildlife filmmaking and community-based filmmaking. There I met again one of my rivermen. I call my life-changing people as rivermen. So there's this book called Siddhartha by Herman Hassel.
Okay.
So again, one of the rivermen I met in my journey in Green Hub, his name is Nitin Das sir and Sunil Chauhan. And the whole array of friends like Devashish, Manas, Gaurav, Pramod. So all of them has given a lot in my life. So I think all of them are my inspiration, including the Amis crew and my band Bottle Rockets India.
It's good to know that, you know, about your family, your friends, how they supported you.
Privileged.
Yeah, we can say that actually. Can you tell us a little about your childhood days, your growing up years?
So again, I would say that the base of who I am at this point of time was built or was sculpted when I was young, or especially in my childhood days, because I believe that More than my parents, I've spent my time with my grandmom, so my Abu and my Aita from both the ends. So I think being with them, trying to understand more about nature, and also trying to understand the whole idea of living in harmony, you know, irrespective of which caste you belong to, which religion you belong to, you know, in a time where everything is so polarized, you know, I think the seed of living in harmony, the seed of living together, and appreciating and acknowledging diversity is something that I got from my Aita and Abu, and I owe a lot to them. And also the whole idea of telling stories and listening to stories came from them. So my childhood memory revolves around these two ladies,
Abu and Aita.
Yeah.
They actually, you know, these two people, they often play a great role in one's life.
Absolutely.
Even my Aita, I call her Aitama actually.
Oh, nice.
So she's actually the one, you know, inspiring me to be about films, this industry.
Oh, great.
So when you said that,
is she also into the films?
She is, she was actually. She used to work with Bhupen Hazarika earlier, like during her, before she got married. After then, she got married and then with the family and all.
Okay. It will be an honor to meet her someday.
I did tell her about this interview. I did tell her. So
great.
After I go home also, I will tell her how this went.
It would be nice.
So, Argadeep, how far do you think it's necessary for one to be a part of mass communication, or one needs to pursue mass communication to be a part of this entertainment world, as you have also done your masters?
So I think it's always good to have some sort of a base, you know. I don't know how much important it is to have that sort of a nurturing or orientation, but it always helps, you know. If you know how the camera works, if you know how to speak in front of the camera, so that really adds.
Yeah.
And what I feel for me, MassCom was also very important because there is this subject called film studies. So what helped? Film studies did to me is like it exposed me to the world cinema. So which usually in our day-to-day mundane life, we are so much engrossed to the whole idea of Bollywood and Hollywood that until and unless you have someone to tell you, or until and unless you get that exposure to be around someone, it is very difficult at some point of time to know about world cinema. So I think when you pursue a course like mass communication, then you get that basic orientation of film studies where you came to know about various world cinemas, you know. And also at the same time, you get familiar with the whole idea of lights, camera, editing, sound. So, you know, so this thing helps in a way. Because for a person who just go and get in front of a setup like this may get intimidated and overwhelmed. So if you are nurtured and get the basic orientation, that always helps.
It especially becomes like a plus point.
Absolutely. And especially if you want to do something like acting or I think filmmaking, then I think the basic understanding of the whole gadgets and also the narrative and the theories is necessary.
Yes.
At some point of time. Yeah. But again, it's a very personal thing. Because at the end of the day, you'll have to do it and you'll have to study. So self-study is also equally important.
Important, right. Like apart from music and film, we know that you have been, you know, connected or have been working for certain causes, like some social causes. We have been knowing that you are attached to the world, and then you have been doing a lot actually. So climate change is a grave issue in the present times, you know, it has been becoming the alarming issue here. Like everywhere, the whole world is at an alarming state. So, can you tell our viewers a little bit about what is climate change and what we as layman or common people can take our small bit steps to help curb the issue?
I think I won't go to the details or the theories of climate change, but if somebody who is watching this session, I think it's September and we are still sweating like anything, right? So why is it happening? Why there is no rainfall as such? You know, why there is no monsoon in its correct time? So these are certain questions that I think we as citizens of this world, not just India, have to think. You know, why there is excessive extreme heat, why there is forest burning, no, forest fire. So these are certain questions that we'll have to ask ourselves. And when we'll start asking these questions, I think we'll automatically understand what is happening. Because we are feeling it, but we are not trying to accept it. So that is the biggest problem. That is not just happening from the citizens' end, but also from the end of the authorities. Those who have the political power, they are not showing the political will to accept the fact that there is a global issue like climate change and global warming. So I think it is very important that we as citizens start realizing it and also start questioning the government and the authority that climate change is no joke. You know, the glaciers are melting, the water level is increasing. You know, now the floods have become so, even if we see the last year's flood, so the intensity has gone so up. Maybe the duration has shortened, but the intensity wise, every now and then we hear news of, you know, cloudburst or landslides. So I think we'll have to be more conscious about the whole idea of development.
Can you tell us a little bit about your upcoming projects?
So right now we're concentrating more with our band and with our music. So hopefully by the end of this year we can release at least two of our own compositions, because it's been a while. We've been saying this for a while now to our listeners that we'll be releasing our songs soon, but somehow I don't know why that we've been not being able to release them. But hopefully by the end of this year at least two songs we are targeting. And film wise there are a few short films that I'm engaged with, hopefully which will release again by the end of this year. And there is a feature film project that might start by the end of this year again. And other than that, there are a few documentary films that I'm currently working with, so which will get released or might get sent to the different festivals.
We'll be eagerly waiting for your upcoming projects.
Thank you.
As we have come towards the end of the interview, I'm sure you have enjoyed the candid session. So Argateev, a message that you would like to give away to the youth who are planning to venture into this entertainment industry?
I think it's very important, no matter what you do, it is very important to be very sincere and honest about your work and about your approach towards it. I think that's the key to do anything, whether you want to be in the entertainment industry or you want to do or you want to live a better life. I think to be honest with yourself and to be sincere with what you do is the key. And you have to enjoy every moment, you know. There's no pressure as such. If you start taking things too much as a burden, then I think you won't be able to enjoy anything. So it is very important to enjoy every moment of your life. And yeah, that's it.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.